Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again, and this is the little stove we're working on. I put some nuts down in the bottom, as I had said I would. We're out here in my, we'll call it a garage carport, but there's plenty of air around here, so there's no problem with that. And I'm going to dub this stove the Elfie stove in honor of the one that asked me to build it. And we're going to fire this thing up and see how it works. First of all, what I'm going to use for fuel here is these hardwood pellets. Now that noise you hear in the background, that is rain. Real rain. We haven't seen any real rain in several months, so it's a welcome addition to today's weather. It did cut down on my ability to turn wrenches outside, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to put 24 ounces of these pellets, not by weight but by volume. I'm going to scoop two 12 ounce cans of pellets into this stove. Looking down into the stove now, you can see that's about two-thirds full, maybe pretty close. Considering this is a little over a quart container, 24 ounces, that would be about two-thirds. Okay, next thing we're going to do is put some highly combustible stuff on top. In this particular case, I think I'm going to throw in some pine shavings, but you could easily use cardboard or something like that, as long as you don't put so much in there as to choke the fire out. All right, I added about an inch or so of pine shavings to the top, and now I'm going to just light it up. You know, some people would say, oh, that's cheating. Well, I didn't sit there and burn it for half an hour, but that's what I had handy at the time. And in this damp weather, matches don't work so well. So now what we're going to basically witness is that the pine shavings will burn off the top, and they should start the primary burn on the top. And hopefully those notches I cut in there are big enough to allow for a good secondary flame. Otherwise, we'll make them bigger and try it again. Now, if you can see, now this is on a tripod and I'm looking at it from a different angle. See, there's my shadow. But I can see already that even those pine shavings are burning smokelessly, which makes me pretty happy. I don't see any secondary burn yet. Interesting way to test your stove to see if it's burning properly. You won't see any glowing on top up here. In fact, if you drop something into the stove, like a piece of paper, rather than it flaring up and catching on fire, it will just sit there and slowly turn black. I'm going to shut this off and we'll turn it back on again as it gets deeper into the fire. I don't know if you can see it or not, but right here and right there, these jets, and here's another one over here, are producing a blue hot flame. So they're working. I think they could be a little bit bigger. And I don't know, because I can't see the viewfinder, whether or not from a perspective you can see, but in the middle down here, in where the tip of the knife is there, there is no flame in there. As I disturb it, I can move the flame, but there's no flame in there, which means what's burning up here on top is the secondary gas flame. And you, hopefully you can see how absolutely blue hot that is. It's working wonderfully well. I will open up the secondary vents. I'm going to turn the light off. There, maybe that gives a better picture. If the secondary burn vents were a little bit larger, it might work a little bit better, but I'm really quite impressed. The Elfie stove works really well. So there you go. Okay, now in case anybody's wondering, Elfie is what I call Mailroom Elf. So if you haven't checked out Mailroom Elf's channel, go check it out. It's a fun channel. I enjoy it. I see all eight of my secondary jets now are burning properly, and they are providing all of the secondary air for this flame up on top. So 100% of the secondary burn that's coming from inside is coming from there, and the rest of the flame, let's see how hot. The last time I burned one of my stoves, I melted aluminum with it. And it didn't take very long. Well, there it is. It's not only melting it, but it's actually burning the aluminum out on the ends. The end of the aluminum there is actually catching on fire. She's a hot one. Sure is. Well, there you have it, folks. The Elfie stove. I will open up those jets just a tiny little bit, probably not an awful lot because it looks real well. One thing I can say you're going to have to do is have to place something similar to this on the top of the stove as a pot separator. It's not quite big enough. Of course, this would be way too tall. And then, of course, since it's got the vent, or the, it's got a grate in it, and the grate was acting as a combustion spark arrestor, killing the flame. That's interesting. And, of course, I would expect one just a little bit big around and cut off so that you have, oh, an inch and a half or so between here. And of course, if you're outside, you would want to have some kind of a wind break. But all in all, I would say that's the best one I built yet. And to give you an idea, the last time I burned my other one, it burned for way over an hour on this is a salmon can. Actually, it's two salmon cans jammed together, but on two salmon cans of pellets, it burned way over an hour. And until I put that pot stand off on top of it and cut the flame down, there wasn't any smoke in here at all. I have chronic bronchitis. I can't handle the smoke at all. So this is really something. And it's quite warm out today and high humidity, so it is way not comfortable here being around that flame. Anyway, any questions from anybody, by all means, post them in the comment sections. I'll be happy to answer whatever I can. Hopefully the previous video was well enough explanatory. What do we get at the other end? Okay, a lot of people want to say biochar. If you're watching it when the flame goes out, and you cover it up with a pot so that it extinguishes the flame, then you will have about a can full of biochar left over. If you don't, it will burn like charcoal and all you'll have left is a fine ash. So I guess basically it's up to you. If you're really interested in biochar, you can do it. I don't know if I'm going to mess with these jets. I think they're working wonderfully well. I'm looking at them here and they're easily taking care of all the flame. I guess the question will be when we put a pot on top, whether there's enough air coming through here, through there to support the combustion with a pot. Anyway, there you go, Elfie. Mailroom Elf. This one's for you. Any questions, by all means, give me a holler. Kevin Bacon. Bye now.